Hi, I'm Vinny Bhutani, and I'm going to introduce you to both a beautiful baby, Isabel, and her dad. And today, as we speak to the parents and learn to know Isabel, as I hope to talk to you about what I do when I look at a baby in my examination room to see how alert and interactive the baby is. So the focus of my conversation is related to looking at the baby's alertness, interactivity, and social behavior. All of that informs me that this baby is actually healthy, because if the baby is unable to perform in the social interaction, then that would have me concerned. And I'll talk about a little bit about that at the end of my talk. So here we go. Here is baby Isabel, and she is being held by her dad, and she's only 5 days old. So she already has an experience of seeing her parents. And what you'd like to see is what she does when she is interacting with her parents and as her dad speaks to her and how that process goes.
Isabel. Hi. Hi, Isabel. How are you? Oh, did you drink a lot of milk? Yes, you did. Oh, you're smiling. I think it's your first smile. Yeah. Oh, Isabel. Hi. It's Appa.
So what you can see is how she is starting to interact with her dad. Her eyes open gently. She's not yet focused on his face at this time, but she's reacting to the touch and the voice and with the facial grimacing and her faces. Now, as the dad starts to have an active interaction with her so that you can see that more visibly, is that as he speaks to her, what happens?
Isabel, hi. Hey, it's Appa. How are you? Aw, cute. Hi, Isabel. Belle, hey. Oh, look at Appa. Hi, Isabel.
So she's performing on cue. She's opened her eyes, fluttered her eyes, and then as you see, she starts to focus. You can actually see her eyeballs starting to converge as she's trying to focus. Not doing it very well at this time, but well enough to tell me that she's able to focus. And then as the daddy smiles and speaks to her, let's see how she does.
Isabel, it's Appa. How are you? You're so cute, Isabel. Yeah, yeah, you're doing great. Oh, you're so cute. Good job.
You see her smile? That's the idea. That indicates to me a healthy wellness and an intact neurological system at this point, which is very important to know. Now let us see what she does with a stranger. This was a familiar face. She has already been used to her dad's voice throughout her pregnancy and fetal state, and now is actually learning to see him. And she has identified him to be a friendly face. What's her reaction to a stranger? May I, Dad? Hello, Isabel. Thank you for the privilege. All right. Now, here's Isabel, and she has no idea where she is and who this person is. Good morning, Isabel. Hello. Okay, you want to get comfortable? Oh, there was a little burp over there. Hello, Isabel. Good morning. Now, when she yawns like this or opens her mouth, that is your opportunity to look into her mouth cavity and see what the structures are within the mouth. Now, Isabel, I think the light is a little too bright over here, and if you can dim the lights down, perhaps she may open her eyes. All right, she's very gentle. There we go. She sees her smiling. She's reacting to my voice. She knows that her predatory voice. And she's looking at me. And you can actually make that contact that when she opened her eyes, they were slightly deviated towards my voice and my face. Maybe I was imagining it. So let's see if she does that again. Hello, Isabel. Good morning. Did you have a nice feed? I know that your dad just fed you. Was that nice? So it's important as you're speaking to the baby to keep your voice soft and gentle and modulated. You can't mimic the voice of mom or dad, but these are the voices she's going to get used to. And what I want to make sure that when she opens her eyes, that I'm smiling. She is learning to how to differentiate a friendly face from a foe. Remember, facial recognition is a very common mammalian feature. Happens in all mammals and in all beings. And so this interaction tells me that she has an intact system both for vision and what it means for early cognition. And that is important. Now, she has gone through a healthy birthing process, haven't you, Isabel? You had a good birthing process. Your transition has been good, and you're starting to look at me and listen to me as I pontificate. But what is important to know that had you been exposed to stresses, like situations like a low oxygen or a low blood glucose or a high bilirubin value, then this interaction may have been interfered with. So that is why, especially in babies who have had phototherapy, after their phototherapy, I go back and check to see how well their social contact is. So that's this social contact informs me not only at birth or before I discharge the baby, but also after I have done any intervention. Babies who are unable to have a social interaction as she does, as she tries to open her eyes and look at me, as they may have a blank stare. And we don't want to see a baby having a blank stare. That would be the first worrisome feature that a baby may show. And it's only you who can recognize this after you have interacted with the baby in this way. So I'm going to give the baby back to the dad and see how she revisits him after having been with a stranger and how she reacts to a friendly face. And there you see, she's already opening her eyes. She knows that the person is different. And she, dad will speak to her.
Hi, Isabel. It's Appa. Isabel. Are you okay? You have a nice lunch? Yeah, are you still hungry? Isabel.
All right. That tells me that she's able to really recognize a familiar face. And her behavior with me was slightly different, but was not fearful. She did not start to cry right away. That is because I made sure that I did not make her cry. So here we are. We are pretending at this point that if Isabel was not well and was placed on a warmer flat surface, so a baby who's just been born and is making a transition would be on a surface like this. And you may be watching a baby like this for either a low blood sugar or the transition after birth or her breathing pattern. In that situation, you still want to know if that is affecting the baby in any negative way. To do that, as you watch her, she's fairly calm, she's steady, and then I will speak to her and see what she does and then make a maneuver that I bring my face close to her face to face. So that if I can get her eyes to open at that time and see what her interaction is, that would be very informative. All right, settle down. Let's give her a few minutes. All right. Okay, calm down. Here we go. All right. Hello, Isabel. Good morning. How are you feeling? Isabel. All right. This is your friendly doctor right here. Okay, good. Are you hearing my voice? Are you starting to recognize it? Let's see what you will do. Let's see if we can get your face like this. Hello, Isabel. Hi. Can you see me? I have to have a direct eye-to-eye contact with you. And so that means that I need to bring my eyes aligned to your eyes. Hello, Isabel. Good morning. You're too sleepy at this time. Hello, Isabel. Isabel. Isabel, good morning. Good morning. Right, she's not making any action right now, so let's just wait. She's so comfortable and asleep. Is this warm? Hello, Isabel. Isabel, you have a little brother. What's his brother's name? Have you met your brother yet? Hello, Isabel. All right. I'm just going to see if I can wake her up. Good morning. Hello. Okay. Isabel. 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 Okay. While I'm doing this maneuver and trying to look into her eyes, I won't get to get close to her face. But during that time, I should not be talking, and I don't want to be breathing on her face. In a baby that is not well, you will see the baby will not have an interaction with me. So she's actually acting that, right? And if I can have her eyes open as she's more awake, I'm looking for the fact whether she continues to have an eye contact with me, or what I'm worried about and I want to make sure that she doesn't have is a blank stare. If it's a blank stare, then I need to examine the baby more closely to figure out whether that is really true. And if there is a situation of a blank stare, then that's a baby I want to watch and follow more closely.